in terms of the mandate, the individual mandate, the relationship between states and the federal government or individual citizens in the federal government, are we better off, worse off, or the same long term, looking forward? And I think the answer is we're not better off. We may not be worse off because of the decision refusing to expand the commerce power and the fairly strong nature of that. I mean, seven justices really saying we're not going there. So that argument's now off the table for a future Congress that wants to further intrude into people's lives, into state authority by relying on the Commerce Clause. Now, unfortunately, the court has invited an alternative way for the Congress to get to the same end, which is by using its taxing power. But I do think that's preferable given two bad choices, because let's just be very blunt about it. In order to get this bill passed, it was necessary from a political standpoint for the President of the United States and for many members of Congress to stand up in front of the television cameras and tell the people they represent, this is not a tax. I'm not taxing you. I'm doing something else. And the court today essentially called that bluff. It is now going to be essential for folks perhaps a little more on the left of the political spectrum, or wherever they are, how you describe them, folks who want to expand the tax and spend role of the federal government, to say that is what we are doing. And I think that there are going to be some political checks on that going forward, that in many ways the Democratic majority in Congress and the Obama administration avoided by trying to recharacterize this. So there is a silver lining in this dark cloud from the standpoint of those of us who objected to how we got here. Obviously, we didn't get the outcome we wanted, but I think there are some nuggets in here that will be useful going forward.